For the video today, we are going to be making a GIF and cutting out the different elements to align them into making one overall animation. So for this animation, we will be using a already existing one of SpongeBob here. Let's see it happening. And then what we'll be doing is cutting the characters out from their background and give them a different location, as well as superimposing two other faces onto those characters and giving them a different background. So taking one overall GIF and then redesigning it to be our own and with a bit of a twist to it. So the first thing, what I'm going to do is go choose the frames that I want from the overall animation. And so I will go in and pen tool all of these individual frames that will work for our project. So we have one overall piece cut out right now. I'm going to copy this, go to paths. While you see our little icon selected, marquee tool. Now it's the marching ants. Now we go back to our layers. Back to our layers. Back to our first frame. Now we go edit, copy, edit, paste. Now we have our first individual frame. And we'll go turn those both off. Turn on our next frame that we'll use, this one here. Do the same process over and over again for all the frames that you'll need, and then save all of the individual files of the individual frames. Now that I have all the individual frames cut out and saved, the next thing I want to do is cut out the individual people and use those as to start to superimpose them over the SpongeBob characters. So I'll be going and pen tooling the people from the background and pen tooling just their faces. So now I'm going to try to erase part of their faces to make them blend better as the individual scenes. So we'll try them, choose one of the scenes, and work from there. Once you have uploaded all of your individual frames, again by doing File, Open, and Place, so they're all in the same document together, what you'll need to do is go and rename all of your individual stills so that Photopea knows that they are going to be an animation. So to do that, you double-click on the name, like so, and you want it to be underscore A underscore. So you want to do that for all of your you can name them So I'll just name them frame one, frame two, all the way up. So again, underscore A, underscore space, and then you can name them whatever you need them to be. Again, make sure the underscore A underscore is in every one so that they will render as the animation. So then you go to File, Export, GIF, and there you go. You have your little sample video here. You can change the speed, so if you want to be slower, if you want to be faster. Keep quality at 100%. And hit save, and that is what you'll be turning in, your animated GIF.